Yeah, Safelane Queen has been very popular during all of TI5, actually. During the group stage, it was popularized.
So is this Lina Safelane, or is it going to be Lina off?
This is kind of what I expected to happen, that you needed
TA really shutting down the Storm Spirit top lane. They're chasing down March and Silent. He's got a very, very good static link off here. 70 damage, 84 damage total. Febby could be in trouble. If he gets in range and Silent's right clicks, and will allow that's with the slow. They'll be able to find themselves first blood, and now they're going to look for more. The damage from Silent is just too much, and it's going to be a second kill there up at the top of the river here for the side of Empire. What a start there for the Dire. Coming up to 1900 gold, has yet to build into his first item. Getting the slow here onto always want to fly, but he's just going to drop the death ward, and with the bounces, actually bouncing towards QO, Silent coming in as well, does get stood up, and QO only just living here through that one, does get the refraction out to avoid the maledict damage. Mid lane, Nuts is going to fall though, and now Silent, he's looking for more, stealing the damage of QO. QO, can he quite find it? The bounces, the cast, and now the plasma field, QO's down, the resolution coming in, the five Febby as well, double kill for Silent. Empire coming out on top every time here, 11 minutes in, 9-2.
They're Hex from Nuts and follow up from KP.
They're just going to find KP indeed with Resolution zipping in. They'll take the Lina kill. Empire finding something in return. QO contemplating where to go, and he's actually going to go for always want to fly here. And Witch Doctor on his own isn't going to be able to do anything. Double kill here for QO. Now Resolution, Silent, and Yoku moving in. They do have a Sonic Wave available here on the quad. He's going to go up to the high ground here, get the slow onto Nuts. Resolution moving forward now to the high ground, trying to do what they can to control him. We'll get the slow onto Nuts. Nuts is going to go down. QO will be able to get himself away there with the haste rune. Is he going to be tanky enough? That's the question. Jumping straight in, they're looking for Silent. They burst him down. Doesn't get the chance to use the mech here. Fantastic initiation there from Phoenix. But now the death ward onto QO. QO, he's got to kill the Witch Doctor. No! The Witch Doctor kills him! Always want to fly, and they'll find the IO as well. Aloha Dark's caught embracing himself up. March is going to be able to find the kill with the help of the stun from KP. And it's going to end at 3-3. But maybe more resolution. He's not done yet. Moving forward onto KP. KP trying to juke it out. But Yoku's there with the double kill. March trying to do what he can with the quill spray. This will be a buyback. Trying to help out March in this fight. Can he turn this one around? Resolution still got mana to zip away. There was... Oh, he got it! He got it! Oh, he got the Queen of Pain! He got it! He got a mega kill streak! The buyback from Febby there with the spirits doing it for the team. What an IO buyback.
He got, like, no gold out of it, though, because he just bought back
his own. And also Resolution coming down the river here as well. So, of course, March, you've got to be careful on this Bristleback. And they're going to go for him here. He's all alone. Always want to fly. We'll move in and now. Resolution zipping forward. March standing alone for too long with the death ward as well from Always Want to Fly. Bristleback just going to evaporate. No backup there from the side of MVP.
When March plays Bristleback, he's not used to dying this fast at minute 16. With the other games we've seen from MVP, his Bristle hasn't been counterpicked that hard. So you can easily get into a false feeling of safety.
There is going to be the static link available. Should have with the backup from the stun from KP. Febby there with a relocate, very nicely securing the side of Phoenix that kill. Resolution with an invis rune. Is he going to try and fight this? He's got the backup of Yoku. Yoku's got a sonic wave available. QO and KP sticking around. Resolution's going to go straight for KP. Looking for the leader, but the KP will get the stun. Now the terror from Febby. KP's going to lift the Laguna Blade. He turns it around, takes down the storm. Now with the stun from Nuts, the Light Striker Ray KP. Himself and over with the team there. A fantastic performance from Phoenix there in their own jungle.
I can't remember. It's weird because he's almost level 9, and usually at this point the curse has been used once or twice because it's such a good
one. Bottom lane, they want to try and go for Yoku. A blink into the tree line is incredibly low. March can find the quill spray. Oh, it's just not in range. Yoku's going to be alright. March has intention towards a lower dance. A lower dance with the corner brace by himself. Stop. Yoku with the sonic wave trying to get Febby. Now a resolution going in to finish it off, but Febby, he's trying to kill him. It's not going to be enough. He will go down. March unable to save him there with a mech, but QO is the one trying to clean up here. Diving deep, looking for always want to fly in the tree line. Will he find it? The urn. It was enough heals, but now the trap. Give Division, the cast holding QO back. The Witch Doctor's going to escape for the time. One more hit will finish him off. QO finally finding the kill. Now Yoku, what's he going to be able to do here? He's going to hold the TA in place here with the Yules. But he's got to blink away. Can't stick around this QO TA who... Actually going to smoke up here now on the side of Empire. Can they get a jump onto Phoenix? Moving towards the Ancients. Febby's actually going to dispel the smoke on Silent. And Resolution just going to go straight in for the IO. But they're going to be able to keep him alive here. Holding them back. And they might even turn this one around. MVP. Death Ward has been dropped. But it's KP from the low ground. The Laguna Blade onto Silent. Silent's seen a lot of damage. The Death Ward from Always Want to Fly. It's not quite enough. Bristleback's going to live. Finally goes down here. But he got himself a double kill with 440. 4-0 is dropping on the side of Empire. And that was a smoke gone wrong.
They would have to go for an actual hard TP back to the top lane.
think they'll be content if they can find.
Oh, Razor could be in trouble here.
And there's March moving forward and Silent. He's got the Cold Embrace here. It's going to be fine for the time being. If you're going to be thrown out, now the Death Ward in a very nice position here, doing a fair with the Sonic Wave. Febby getting low, but they've already killed the Wyvern here at the side of MVP, and they're looking for more. Silent, he gets stunned up. March trying to move, and he's just two down. Tanky Resolution's out of mana, and there's a damage for Kyo. Novi trying to get himself in. We'll get it. Double kill for Kyo. One, two. He needs one more. That's going to do it. No, he needs the final one. He's got it. A triple kill for Kyo. Now Silent chasing down March. We'll find the kill with the help of Yoku and Resolution. And it's in fact just Kyo that's left alive. Will be able to blink himself out. Resolution is not happy. He wants Kyo dead. He's going to be able to, well, it's going to be the hell. The Karina Pain level of yours holding Kyo in place. Kyo just trying to turn it. He's got the Aegis. Now they've got to kill him a second time here. They've got to be careful. Kyo is a bit of a glass cannon. He does a hell of a lot of damage here. He's just going to try and meld himself up. They haven't got detection. And Kyo, he's out. Blinks away. No! Oh, he tries to find Yoku as well. Won't quite get away with it. And Resolution trying to zip forward. He's only got a little bit of mana. Oh, oh, you want to go? Oh, my God. And now Kyo's going for more. He's looking for Silent. He's going to get it. What? Oh, my God. Double kill for Kyo. This man, you can't kill him. You don't want to kill him because he'll turn around. He'll kill you. He'll kill your friends. He'll kill your family. My goodness. This man is... he's a maniac, and now he's going to go for the base. Fortification coming out for the side of Empire. He's just ready to go. Oh, Yoku, you know what happened? Like, yeah, you've got to blink yourself away. He's fine, he's got Refraction, he's good.
No.
Game. Oh, Laguna Blade there, that's a Death Wish. Okay, he's overstepped the mark this time. Kyo's going to go down. March on the front line. Febby, actually doing a fair bit to a low hard dance. And KP with the stun onto Silent. Febby, just helping KP get himself out. There's going to be a re-reading code back out. March is on his own now. And he's in a bit of trouble. He's going to need some kind of help. I don't think it's on its way. He's been left alone, zipping in. They'll find the kill. And okay, they do kill Kyo. So they find a lot of things in return, but it's still Kyo. He's still...
Resolution. A little bit too excited there.
To be careful of Nuts with the blink here. He's going to go straight in here. There's a TP from the Lina. Corn Embrace. I don't know if that's going to help him. He's been Glimmer Caped up as well. They've dropped a sentry. They've got the vision. But now he's just going to zip straight in. Resolution looking to pick off Febby here. Can he find the kill? No, Febby with the Glimmer Cape. He's going to be okay. Resolution can't find that kill. Gets himself away. Oh, he's actually, what's he found? He's found Nuts. Nuts. Oh, looking for the stun. Resolution actually out of mana here. Nuts should be able to chase this. He's got a blink in a couple of seconds.
He's screwed.
He's got no mana at all. Yoku is there. Yoku needs to do something to help him. Yoku picking up an Invis Rune, bottling up as well. They've got a Sonic Wave. They should be able to do something if they want to try and fight. There's your Sonic Wave. Bring in Nuts slow, but he gets tethered up by Febby. And KP and Nuts, they want to look for more. Moving into the Dire Jungle here. Relocate. They're going to relocate in for Hodge. Nuts with the finger. It's the global finger. The low on Nuts getting low. He's got the Cold Embrace. He's going to be fine for the time being, but the Whites want to fly, getting picked up by Kyo. And now low on Nuts is going to go down as well. Two heroes falling on the side of Empire. And I've got to say, the IO performance has been fantastic this match from Febby.
I was about to say that was a really good play from Empire. The way they bailed out Resolution there was actually really good. Of course, the relocate will catch them on the way back as they thought they were safe. Now their barracks are under attack. I don't know if they can hold this. They have to buy back the Wyvern.
They've got to get him back.
At least to have a chance.
Oh, Resolution. He's trying to do it with the Vortex. Pulling him, but March leading forward here. He's harassing them back. He's two down, tanking the Bristleback. They've got to try and fight around him here. Oh, lower does. One, two. Kyo finds the kill. He's going to look for Silent. One, two. It is the third one. Four, four, maybe. There we go. He's got it. It's a double kill. And now he's going to move in for more. Resolution tries to get back with the stun. The Light Striker is a triple kill for Kyo on the TA. Now he'll go for the rags here with the back of his team. Three heroes down on the side of Empire. None with buyback available. Yoku. Yeah, I was going to say you want to blink away from that one. They're going to look towards the tier three in the mid. And Empire just falling apart at this point. This could be the winning push from MVP. Or at least a very damaging one if they find a further set of racks.
It's going to take pretty much a miracle at this point for Empire to be able to hold their base. They're going to lose.
Oh, he's got it! He's got it! GG! Save it! Save the Witch Doctor's humility! Don't put him up against this anymore! It's over! MVP take game one in an incredible fashion, Sin.
That was absolutely phenomenal. I personally feel like Empire had a really good draft against them. So they flat out just got outplayed. They lost their mid lane really hard
as well. But Lina. I think MVP are just going to bring the action in again. And it's about how Empire can control
that. Oh, goodness. Kyo Lina.
Wow.
Wow.
He wants this exact thing to happen.
Oh, the cask here on top lane between Yoke and Lotus. They're moving in onto Nuts here. They want to find the Witch Doctor, and the punch is doing a hell of a lot in Nuts with the Voodoo Restoration. Will be enough to get him back towards the tower. Now he's just going to turn back in. And Lotus does being chased down by KP. KP should be able to find first blood here, but the south coming out. Doppelganger forward. They'll find him in the river. Febby's there as well. They're going to try and give this to KP. But as you know, Febby will just take it. First blood there for the side of MVP.
But the second thing in is Lina
is
actually
nice
really
as well.
Good against Anti.
Huo's rotated down. It has got the Laguna Blade available. It's a question if they want to dive this. I think they might, because always want to fly incredibly low. They're going to turn their attention towards him. March heading forward. There's been a TP in from Resolution. Looking for a defense. They'll find always want to fly here. That's going to be the first kill. Stun onto Silent. They've got to be careful at this TA, because now TA is going to turn their attention towards Huo.
If Huo knew that Silent hasn't skilled Spells Shield, I think he could kill him right now. Might realize with the damage his spells are doing, but...
At the same time, top lane, Witch Doctor able to find a kill there onto the Undying. And they should be able to clear the Tombstone out as well. And off the back of that, they may even try and look for a Low Heart Dance. The cast going forward, KP with the Lance as well. He's going in for this one. He's got to be careful. I mean, a Low Heart Dance is out of mana. He could just afford to do this. The runaround, ring around the Rosie is going to pay off here. They won't be able to get him. An Anti-Mage at the same time, killing Spirit Breaker, Resolution moving in onto Huo. Huo, look for the Jukes. Is he going to find it? Brain Sap from Always Wanna Fly finds the kill there. So, kills happening on both sides of the map here.
There's the only really good Mana Void target, as I talked about earlier, when you pick Anti-Mage's early game contribution to teamfights, it's generally Mana Voiding a key target. The only one who's really valuable to land it on is Lina.
Silent blinking and aggressive there. March can find some bashes here. He's going to be a lot of trouble. Shuriken coming out from Febby. They're going to try and chase this. He needs a bash March. Oh, he doesn't get it. Silent is able to blink himself out into the tree line, healed up by Yoku's Soul Rip. And they will be okay, but Q's come down here as well. He's got a Laguna Blade. If he can find anyone, if he can find Silent, the bounces from the Shuriken doing a lot to slow down Empire. And if Febby moving in, there's going to be the charge from March as well. Yoku drops the Tombstone, but they're just going to fight on the other side of it. Moving straight in, the dodge! The dodge is there, but now with the Death Ward thrown down from Nuts, it's too much. He finds one. March, he gets the second double kill for the Spirit Breaker. Three heroes falling on the side of Empire. And
it
MVP.
Luna, it didn't even matter.
Oh, if Empire can jump in now. Low on Dance, High Shards going in, but the charge out from March. They're trying to start. Tombstone is on the high ground. They're there for it, though. Look at it go, Nuts. The Mana Void there to cancel it. And they've already found one. Huo now on a killing spree. March with the bashes. Low on Dance moving in onto Huo. Huo looking for Silent, but Silent. He's going to be able to get himself out of being. Oh, they've lost the bait. Now the charge from March onto Yoku. Now the spree lost onto Resolution. The illusions. Will they kill him though? The Meld is there. KP's trying to fight him, but they haven't got detection. KP going back for Low on Dance. Resolution. He's got a triple kill on Yoku because of the Tombstone. And this is an side of MVP here. That Silent was able to pick up the Aegis and finish off Roshan. No, oh, they get the Spirit Breaker. Empire, they're hitting back hard here. 13 for 17. And Yoku just TPs out. What a Tombstone. What an Undying.
Impact not so high.
He's been spotted out. March, Huo, Nuts hiding in the trees. Which way is this fight going to go? Charge up to the dust. Laguna Blade. But the Tombstone's been dropped down. They need to do something about this. The Death Ward is doing a lot of Silent with the Mana Void. Will cancel the channeling. Nuts is having to run now. Yoku is doing so much. They just can't do anything about the Undying. They'll finally be able to take down the Tombstone. But there's already a double kill for Resolution. Silent and Resolution still sitting at full health. Febby having to get himself out of there. Can't do anything.
Tento with the Guardian Greaves now. To 1500 gold on top of it as well. And they're gonna look for a smoke here, MVP. March leaving the way with a charge straight onto Yoku. They realize that the Undying is the issue, as long as they can stop him from getting anything out. But the Nightmare Dodge there coming out. He actually juked off the damage as well. He's alive, he's in the snowball. The Death Ward doing so much though with the Agonies. Look at the bounces go. They're looking for Silent, the Light Strike onto Silent. He can't break out. Can they kill him? There's gonna be the Ulcers while holding in place. Can he get himself out? No! Double kill for KP. Empire losing three heroes off the back of that fight.
No buyback on Silent. He bought Evilsong. They're going to lose Rax here.
Oh, this is terrible for Empire. 70 seconds without the Anti-Mage. Up to the high ground. MVP go. Can they do it here? The team that were able to take down Newbie in the first round, moving forward to taking down Empire in a potentially a 2-0, unless Empire could do anything spectacular here. 60 seconds still without the Anti-Mage. The pushing power is pretty strong here from MVP. They'll at least be able to take a set of Rax here in the mid lane. And Empire just unable to do anything at the moment without that Anti-Mage. Not even wanting to move forward or jump in at this point. It's a little bit too risky.
They 3-0'd that fight with a Laguna Blade on a creep instead of the Undying.
Very tense bit here for Empire.
They've got to do everything they can to hold onto their base. They're losing it slowly but surely. Kyo just sits there with that attack range, hitting away. And now with the Yules onto Bane, they might try and find this, but Silent jumps straight in first. Cast prone out onto Silent, and now the Deathforce dropped out. They need to get themselves out or cancel this one. But they get, oh! He just able to blink himself out. They will lose. Oh no! Always Want to Fly is actually able to live for a short amount of time. Ends up dying to the Dragon Slave. Now KP moving forward onto lower dust. Silent's trying to help him though. Looking for KP. Silent, what can he do on the animation? He's done quite a lot to KP. Oh, Mana Void finishes off KP and Silent. He's looking for more. He's trying to find Kyo. He'll get it. The Aegis is going to be poured in from the leader, but March, he's still in fight. Febby's going to go down there to Resolution. Double kill for Silent. Kyo is back up. Can they kill Kyo? I think they can. Moving in with Yoku. Resolution. Silent busts the back to them. Oh, the Bloodstone deny will come out. But nonetheless, Empire defending the base there. And Silent doing a hell of a lot of work there for the team.
This is
moving into their jungle.
Silent just bought a Vitality Booster as well. So
he's going all in. Okay, Lohar Dancing has been scouted out. Lightstrike's already been popped. I see the Fiend's Grip used there and cancelled straight away. So Fiend's Grip's not going to be available here for this fight. Now the charge onto a Lohar Dancing. He's been caped up. Now with the Defensive Nightmare, the Deathlord. Look how much he's going to do here. Mana Void coming out there from Silent. He cancels it. A Lohar Dancing will fall though. It's a double kill for Kyo. How much can Silent do? He's looking for Marge. Now he's going to blink forward for Kyo. Kyo's still alive. Will finally go down. KP trying to fight Yoku. Silent. He's got to carry harder. Yoku's falling down. They're going to lose Yoku. It's only Silent. Can Silent kill them all? I don't think he can. He's got to get himself out. Blinks himself away. He's lost the rest of his team.
He is so ice cold. That's actually on.
Oh no, the bounces. The bounces is going to hit him again. No! Oh, they're going to play Silent. Oh, get the blink off. Febby's there with the chase down. Silent, a lot of trouble. Always Want to Fly has turned up. And Bane trying to sacrifice himself potentially for the AM. But KP, look at him run. Look at him go. This man finds the kill. You talk about Bloodseeker moving fast. Look at that PL. It's a mega kill tree for KP. And that's AM down for 90 seconds. He's got buyback. Oh, he's so lucky. He was 2 gold short when he was dead. He's now got it and he's going to use it straight away. I can't believe he only just had enough of that buyback. Without that, Empire could have been such a bad position.
I don't think he knew he was going to have it, to be honest. He's been
they found a Bane. This Bane is in so much trouble. Oh, Always Want to Fly getting taken. Now, Silent, is he going to go for that? He's smoked up. He has the backup of his team. Resolution is there. Can Empire try and take this fight? MVP are looking for Roshan. There's 4 of them on the side of Empire. They're going to go for it. Kyo straight away out to Yoki. Yoki's going to get taken down. He gets taken down. Kyo, he's getting incredibly low here. Silent trying to fight up. The Mana Void coming out. Nuts. Being chased out by Resolution. Resolution, but they lost Silent. Silent's dead. KP, it's too much. It's too much. They're going to look for Resolution as well. Febby and Marge moving forward, looking for the TA. KP, he's in the base. He's looking for the objective. Marge with the bash. Finally, he gets one out. And off the back of that, MVP, they're looking for the top tier. Seconds without AM. Resolution will buy back you on the TA. They need to kill KP, and I don't know if they can. There's only 3 of them left alive here. There's going to be a charge coming through from March on the side of MVP, and MVP just want to fight. KP moving in onto Resolution. The snowball coming out just in time, but Resolution still goes down. It's a monster kill. KP, he's looking for Bane. There's going to be the Nightmare buys him some time, but they still find the kill. Double kill for KP. 4 heroes down. The Phantom Lancer's too much. The results will come back for the Doctors. He's positive. MVP, they're destroying Empire. What can Empire do now without the AM, without the TA? The tier 4's to drop. I think it's over, Sin. I think...
they're doing what they can here, but it's not enough. They're going to lose the Tombstone here as well. And March said in an interview going into this tournament, I don't know how many people actually believed him. He said, think we can
it's
get
over.
To
MVP did it! 2-0 against Empire! They did it! They moved forward yet again! The team that you really need to be keeping your eye on. What a performance once again!
To pressure stronger melee carries than Spectre, and Spectre being super weak, the Rubick and AA can't really do that much.
I think I agree. If you're like this, is great.
Rubick, of course, probably one of the best Rubicks out there in the world right now. Cloud9, we're actually going to have an early level 1 fight over the Bounty Rune. Vaughn is already setting himself up. Hal's going to challenge him. Meanwhile, Ice, though, he's locked inside of the cogs with Misery. That's not a place he wants to be. He'll be giving up first blood. Misery, though, the turnaround kill for VG Gaming. So they did snag the Bounty Rune there on Hal, but gave up the first blood in the process.
So you're meant to be
a little bit ahead, just because you want that faster BKB.
Oh, jump in! Oh, Ice misses out on the hookshot. They might get him, catch Fada. They're trying to catch. Oh, they manage to get the battery cell. Fada's actually going to be locked inside. The Kog Super gets left up at the same time. Ice got his ulti though, and Fada. Here comes Super's Laguna Blade, and last couple of right clicks to secure the kill. And now Misery's in trouble too. He goes down 5-1 already. And Big Daddy No Tails push back as well. Vici Gaming.
Oh, FY wants to get one more. He does have the tether up though. Round's not close enough. Two more right clicks should be able to do it, but long distance tethers away and it's just fine. The rocket's flying in, but he should be just fine. And they, I think they might be aware.
That's a big deal. They're gonna have their heart stack taken away. Fada, I guess who needs supports to stack your own jungle weak? You could just go into the enemy jungle and find some. Oh, call down actually laid out. Super's gonna be slowed down a little bit. Cloud9 really wanted to fight this one. Al's actually gonna jump forward. He wants to go straight for Big Daddy No Tail, trying to catch up. Bone 7's coming inside, but Zoe 2 is Ice, Ice, Ice. He's trying to finish up Big Daddy. Does manage to get it, but the egg, they're stuck in a bad position. Ice, Ice, Ice. He can't go anywhere. The egg's gonna explode on him, stun him up, and Eternal Envy will close the distance, be able to get the kill in the end with the battery assault. Now, they're actually gonna chase for more. How? He's gonna drop incredibly low. One more right strike. No, the neutral keeps. He feeds himself away. Bone 7, one more right click as well, but they want Eternal Envy, and they will have him. Super. He's still finding this one out with Fenrir up against Misery. The sleep gets laid down. Farther away, Bottom's actually not coming over. He's too low to help out, so they're just gonna be a kill on Fenrir. Big Daddy No Tails here. Super realizes he's not getting away. Cloud9 get their vision and even up the kill score 8-8.
And that was so close. I mean, if you look at it, Bone
Man Smoke not working out for them just yet. This is incredibly important. Ice, Ice, Ice has not had that good of an impact. He really needs a kill here, and they will jump on Fada now. All ready to jump in. Ice Blast explodes him, and Ice, Ice, Ice actually makes a quick TP lane. No, Misery stops him. The egg will explode, and how? Oh no, he actually jumped to the egg. Now he's stuck. Stunned up against four heroes. He will end up going down, even if Big Daddy follows him surely to the grave. A 2-for-3 exchange in the favor of Cloud9. Once again, they got a kill on Hao. So incredibly important to keep that Spectre down. Acer or two?
I don't think those are any items that he'd want to hold on to the late game. Oh, and at top, they're actually going to make a move. Hao's getting quite low.
He's got the dagger and will be able to get to the trees. And Ice, Ice, Ice actually now makes his debut into the fight, going for Eternal Envy with on top Ice Blast. They do manage to catch out Hao still in the trees, and Fada will easily clean him. Oh, no, he actually jumped away. Oh, what an ultimate. He went over to Big Daddy, and he's into the trees. He may actually be able to get away with the dagger. Unbelievable. He gets the escape. Meanwhile, Misery goes down. Relocate on top of Super, though. He's on the run. Does manage to get the Light Strike array. The last couple of right clicks is there. Big Daddy gets the kill, gets vengeance for Misery, his fellow support. I still cannot believe that Hao managed to get away with that ultimate. Yeah. Build to try and go for an early Blade Mail, which would be very powerful against certain heroes like the SF. Oh, jump in here in the middle lane. Hao, slowed down by the call down. Gets
Misery
into the
again.
No, the Fiend's Grip actually grabs him. And he's done for. Once again, Vici Gaming just do not have the defensive supports to be able to react.
Oh, they're going for the relocate at bottom. This
Super.
Is a huge dive.
Beautiful Light Strike Array. We'll be able to hold these heroes with the Ice Blast coming in on top. Eternal Envy's hit by that one, but they have no more nukes left. Bone 7 snag as he tried to just dive right through. Needs to be able to get off that Supernova. Bounce back. He will be able to get off just in time, but is rapidly focused down by Vici Gaming. Super on the run. Will be able to keep alive. Zangos with Ice, Ice, Ice. And Cloud9 have overextended themselves on the run. Whoa, what a jump here from FY with that Phoenix dive. Gets some more damage on Eternal Envy. They need one more round of nukes, but it's not going to be there. No, it is. Hookshot jumping in. Ice, Ice, Ice trying to finish him off. The Cog pushback isn't enough damage. FY gets him in the end. A trade up one for one, but FY goes down as well now. Misery running forward. Hao popping the ultimate. He wants to force this fight.
They're throwing out the stuns. Hao.
Misery, he's found Hao. Super, he's trying to stop this one. There goes the hookshot all the way in. Ice, Ice, Ice goes in the back. Fada's gonna call the ultimate, but they've already taken down No Tail with, oh my goodness, what a big combination of plays. Bone 7 and Eternal Envy will single-handedly take out all of VG Gaming. And now they're gonna march straight through the tier 2s, go up to tier 3s as well, see if they can force the buybacks, but there's not a single one out from VG Gaming.
C9 have a 10k advantage, but they still aren't willing to get in the fight. They're not going to be blind for
this
fight. They're walking
dangerous.
Straight up.
Eternal Envy sees this one. Cloud9, they know. They just popped the ward, so they're somewhere nearby. The missed hookshot is there, and now the Supernova is laid out. Super starts going for it. Ice, Ice, Ice trying to get away from his cogs, but he will go down. Misery managed to get the Fiend Scream on top. Super and Fenrir get stunned up. Hao in the background trying to deal with Fada, but he can't do it. Eternal Envy, oh, he's going to get bursted down. They managed to get the Laguna Blade off on top of that one. Three down at the side of Cloud9. Fenrir's going to fall, even it up. 3-for-3. Hao and FY, they're going to force Fada TP back. No, he actually
FY has the ulti.
He wants to try to go for both 7. He lets it. actually going to just chase him down to FY. Grab the infinity.
No! FY stacked it! He's going to get out! Oh, FUT out! He wants the kill desperately, but he's done for! How gets the kill? And FY, the MVP of this match, and it's not even over yet.
If there was any question in the world who the best Rubick player is, FY just completely ended it. You can't make an argument for anybody else. With one Blink Dagger, a Force Staff, and an Aghanim Scepter, this guy's stolen three consecutive game-changing ultimates. How do you give credit to anybody else on VG Gaming?
VG Gaming, really for the first time all game, we're gonna make the jump for Toe Levy's big red.
Here we go!
Go to Talcan, he's in there!
Yes,
no buyback! No buyback for 2 minutes! This is gonna be all on FUT! Can he carry Cloud9 to victory here? Supernova gets popped. How? Trying to chase around Big Daddy No Tail, wanted to get that kill. The Glimmer Cape is keeping him alive, but finally he will get the kill in the end. How does go down? And that's gonna be just the Aegis though. Cloud9 still have to fight this one out. 3 versus 4 is how comes back in. Telekinesis onto both 7. Let's lose the ultimate. FY just showing off at this point in time. VG Gaming though, objective based gaming, are now gonna go for the tier 3 tower and wait for Cloud9 to come to them.
And they've given Hal the cheese now. He has the refresher orb. I mean, he's got money for boots of travel. He can instantly come back in. 6k gold on him, and this is going to mean a lane of racks at least for C9.
They don't want to get picked up. Oh, FUT! He did get the Lincoln Sphere in time. Now he's going to be forced out forward, trying to get away, trying to get somehow out of this stun, but he does. Finally going to fall here. Blows up in a giant explosion. He's got a buyback, but VG Gaming just keep marching forward. Misery's going to be the next target of Hal. Hoping to be able to get that last right click. Does get it before Misery can turn around
and
get the sleep. Hal, he's trying to get away. Manta pops. Chase just in time, and now he's getting away with the Glimmer Cape already. The Rage Racks it down. Hal starts going for more objectives, perhaps. He actually start running through the top lane. Seems like they're going to back away. Eternal Envy. Cheap damage, perhaps. FY's going to jump in. Telekinesis on Misery. They're trying to
push
him
down. So low.
Force Staff has already brought him low. Glimmer Cape is out there. His hook shot.
Oh, Bada's
actually
doesn't...
trying to get away. Dropping BKB. Flats over the top. He's going to go down. The Supernova is down, but Vici Gaming are going to be able to get back in time. Won't really worry about that one. The buyback is there. Now Bone 7 starts jumping for VG Gaming. They're going for the end. They're trying to go straight for the throne, but the glyph is there. It's healing up the throne.
Oh, this is the right.
They're all trying to take up the throne.
They gotta get back here.
VG Gaming trying to go for the defense as fast as possible. How? Starts beating up Eternal Envy. There goes that Aegis on. Eternal Envy now pops a BKB and Satanic.
Oh, they're still going for it.
FUT just playing games, running around the throne as best as possible. Ice, ice, ice.
On the back door protection.
He's gonna go down. The back door protection is healing up the throne. FUT is left alone. Solo up against VG Gaming. He will not have the damage. He tries, but it's not gonna be there. They both fall, and VG Gaming in that defense have just sufficiently taken the game.
There's no buybacks anymore for C9. I can't blame them for going for that play. That was probably their best shot, but it's just not going to be enough. As VG Gaming, they have so many lives to work with. That's almost 10k built up for Super. Like, he's just taunting them at this point. He's saying, I'm not six slotted, but it doesn't even matter. I don't even need travels. I'm so convinced that we've won this game, and how they're going to secure the Mega Creeps before they go for the throne. There's no reason for them to be impatient. 70 minutes in the game, you don't want to throw away this advantage. They're just going to go straight for Mega Creeps and then go for the throne with no buybacks on either of the cores. This is too difficult. Vici already set up around the throne for this.
Mega Creeps are here, and still another 80 seconds on the clock till FUT comes back. Vici Gaming are just taking their time, slowly but surely.
Oh, they're going to go for it again.
Their relocate play. They're going for it desperately, but they've already called the GG. They know there's no help there. There's no help to be found. Cloud9 will lose game number one, Vici Gaming.
What a comeback. That's the most emotion I've ever seen Hal use. Like, he's going insane right now, like he won TI again. But that was...
I'm sure Toby is somewhere out there watching this, and he's just shaking his head as well. So,
you know, you start this game, and you're a Vici Gaming player, just by 3 TPs. You're like, I can do whatever. Sniper.
Wow.
Okay.
Wow.
Holy noses.
These last picks, I'm not surprised that none of us called the
Sniper's been used as a counter for the...
Between both Decay and Shadow Strike now, they are going to be slowed down a bit here.
Oh, they know that Envy used Shadow Strike.
Yeah, he doesn't have to blink away. They're going to go straight for Eternal Envy, and he is stuck up against that Fissure. Hal gets the first blood, and now trying to get away from Big Daddy. No-Tail, Hal motioning up.
2 seconds.
And he has the Decay up, but it's not going to be enough. He just turns around, throws it on Fenrir, but Hal survives.
Vici Gaming, very smartly, even if Misery is going to be full-time stacking, he's not going to have the opportunity to clear through that. Now, FUT, of course,
they've got that snipe.
Dropping low enough for the snipe coming in. They get the kill. Oh, beautiful opportunity. And now, if they take away the stack,
as well. What does Fada have to fall back on? I mean, we always talk about, oh, SFs, they always have a way back into the game, even if the lane is very hard for them. They always have those stacks. They're going to be able to get the kill on No-Tail, picking that one up, but need a little bit more. Fenrir strikes him with the Enchant Totem, and now Eternal Envy will finish off the kill on the support. He needs to blink away. At the same time, we did have some action farther up. Oh, they're actually going to be able to get the kill still on Hal Undying. Picks it up there with the Tombstone, and FY
he has
to run himself away. He still has the Cold Embrace to heal himself up, but Eternal Envy has the damage. He just needs two more right clicks. The one actually keeps FY alive, and he finally does go down. Eternal Envy gets him thanks to the Bloodseeker's Vision. Just because of the natural teamfight dominance that their draft has given them, but VG Gaming, they're going to try and go, starting off with Fada. They're going to jump forward, Fisher to start things off. Already the Tombstone is laid out, but Fada is gone, and now the Vacuum's going to be able to catch Misery on top of that one. The Decrepify is there on the Tombstone without any heroes to back it up. They're not going to be able to do much. The Blood Rite is laid down. VG Gaming will all dodge it, and now Big Daddy No-Tail's in a bad position. Eternal Envy comes in, throws out a big ultimate, will be able to eliminate two, but Eternal Envy with the blink forward is now going to be taken out by Super's Mask of Madness. Well, it looks like Bone 7's going to fall as well with the Assassinate to finish him off. How dominating spree sniper as well. VG Gaming establishing a huge lead here in this game too.
Useful the bucket barrage destroy supports. So
Seven gonna make the initiation here. Cloud9 desperately need to win this fight. Oh! Oh! Vacuum with the Fisher on top. Unbelievable display of coordination from VG Gaming. Quickly win the fight. Three heroes down on the side of Cloud9 and a tier one tower to be picked up for VG.
It's okay, but it's more just the fact that he realizes they need another one.
Super's already throwing the shrapnel in. They will be able to pick up the Aegis, but the question
they still
is,
fight
are
this?
They going to be able to escape? Big Daddy's thrown out the Tombstone immediately, but he's easily going to be cleaned up by the Rocket Barrage. And what a great vacuum, pulling Misery back over that Fisher. The ultimate gets laid out from Fada, but he does not have a TP away. A second life means nothing if you die and die again. Super now grabs the Illusion Root, because why the hell not? Fada is going to be stuck, surrounded by five, and Eternal Envy just sits there knowing he can't do anything to stop the massacre. VG Gaming perhaps are a bit too far forward. Cloud9 are sneaking their way around this one. They're going to be able to force the fight here. Big Daddy No-Tail leading with the Tombstone, trying to slow everyone down. The Blood Rite is laid out. Rupture being placed on Ice. They're going to focus on the Tombstone first, but there goes
that Vacuum!
Nice Vacuum with the Winter's Curse over the top, still controlling three. They almost finish off one. Fada will be able to get off the ultimate. Eternal Envy lets loose his own, and they manage to finish off two already. FY is going to be left, but so too does Queen of Pain fall. Super is left with a minimal amount of HP. They have to finish him off, and both Seven does get him in the end. Cloud9 get four and looking for a fifth now as Fenrir blinks away, will be fine. And this is their opportunity, especially with the heroes far forward. They're going to lead with the Rupture now on how. The pipe is already laid out. Tombstone being placed. There goes the Vacuum. Two-man Fisher. Already the Winter's Curse laid out, and they actually blink backwards. Fada! Oh, dear. I'm not sure if that's what he wanted to do. Now he's threatening the ultimate, but how doesn't seem to care. He's going to keep moving forward. And with BKB, he's going to be completely fine. Two heroes taken out as Super managed to finish off No-Tail thanks to the Assassinate. Rather than forwards, I thought he was going to be in a great position for his ultimate, but that just wasn't there. And now the melee Rax is going to be given up.
Cloud9, oh, that damn,
be careful. Eternal Envy, he goes down. Both Seven now pops the Blade Bell, but it's too late. And now Fada, oh, everything's just falling apart for Cloud9. Fenrir gets threatened by the ultimate from Eternal Envy. How does pick up the double kill towards the end there? And it seems like VG Gaming are all going to be able to. There's it. Cloud9 call a GG. One set of racks, but they know they are so far behind against VG Gaming. They will give up their position here at the International. VG Gaming will move forward.
What a draft by them. It was just...